Henry Ford was born in July 1863 during the midst of our nation's Civil War, and he was from the beginning a natural mechanic. He could lose himself in long hours and days tinkering on watches and figuring out how machines work. After marrying Clara Bryant, he was not the most romantic of husbands. He'd often work his day job and then come home, have supper with his young wife, and then go out to his workshop behind their house, where he would spend 5 or 6 hours tinkering with and experimenting with a gas engine which he was determined to perfect. Eventually, Henry moved to Detroit with Clara, where he became obsessed with the idea of developing a horseless carriage. In June 1903, the Ford Motor Company was born. Ford's rise to fame began with the creation of the most popular automobile America has ever seen, the legendary Model T. Practically from the beginning of his automotive career, Henry Ford had been obsessed with the idea of creating a sort of people's car. The Model T Ford turned out to be the car of Ford's dreams. It would cost around $850 at the first and was built with a new type of steel called vanadium, which was both strong and lightweight. It was a purely no-frills car. It weighed a mere 1,200 pounds, had good power for those days, and a blazing top speed of around 40 miles an hour. The combination of low price and remarkable reliability made the Model T a huge success. It soon outsold every other car on the market, and in time it would come to represent half the cars in the world. In 1913, Ford and some of his leading associates decided to convert their company to assembly line production. The time it took to create a road-ready Model T plummeted. Whereas under the old system, the fastest time had been in just over 12 hours, with an assembly line, they could turn out a new car in about an hour and a half. With increased efficiency, the cars could be built for significantly less cost, and profits began to soar. Ford used most of the increased revenue to lower prices, and the lower those prices went, the more people bought the Model T. Model T Fords cluttered America's roads from California to New York. Henry Ford achieved all his dreams and then some. He became, in time, America's richest man and one of its most famous. But as he aged, he revealed a side of himself that was not attractive. Ford became more and more obsessed with avoiding waste and saving time until people and their needs became irrelevant to him. He also became increasingly dictatorial. He fired many of his smartest and best qualified associates, determined that he alone would run that company without competition or challenge. Once while on vacation, a new model was created as a possible successor to the Model T. When Ford saw what his son, Edsel, and some of his engineers had been working on, he was livid. He went up to the prototype car and ripped off the doors from its hinges. Then he methodically went around that car, smashing parts and ripping off others to demonstrate how monstrous it was to show initiative without the consent and approval of Henry Ford. The once likable young man became a notorious bully as an old man, intimidating the weak and firing those who would not be intimidated. Once his son Edsel had a new wing of the plant begun without his father's knowledge, and when the older Ford learned about it, he had the building stopped immediately. But he refused to fill in the gaping hole that had been dug for the foundation. He wanted his son Edsel and everyone else to pass that hole every day on their way to their jobs and be reminded of what happens when you dare start a project without imploring his permission. In this and many other ways, Ford humiliated and harassed his son Edsel, who was born with a gentle nature and hated confrontation. Edsel eventually developed stomach ulcers and stomach cancer and died several years before his father, at the young age of 49. The older Ford was never the same after his son's death. In his later years, Henry demanded more and more from his workers. The assembly line was accelerated until workers went home dazed and exhausted. Ford created a service department which was more like a mini Gestapo, spying on workers and making sure they towed the line. Talking to a coworker would get you fired, as would taking even the briefest moment to sit down while still on the clock. Anyone found trying to organize the workers into a union would be beaten and then fired. Ford's final years were sad ones. With his mind dulled by strokes, he became less and less engaged in the company that he had founded. For a time, even his wife shut him out, blaming him for their son's death. He sat in company meetings with a detached look, no longer a formidable, intimidating presence, but a lonely, sad old man. Finally, at the age of 83, Henry Ford died with his head on his wife's shoulders. Old age is a time when small seeds become full-grown plants. Whatever you are as a young person, you will likely become far more of in your old age. The disintegration of Henry Ford was a sad one. He started out as a likable young man, fascinated with life, eager to achieve success and to help others in the process. But the passing of time and the maturing of the seeds of his obsessive personality resulted in Ford eventually becoming an irritable, controlling, mean-spirited old man who drove his son to an early grave and alienated most of the associates who had helped make him the success that he was. Henry Ford's biggest problem was simple. It was a lack of Jesus Christ in his life. He was the product of parents who never took religion very seriously, and Henry followed in their footsteps. He eventually abandoned any pretense at Christianity and embraced reincarnation. This allowed him the comfort of believing there's an ultimate purpose in our lives and a meaningful universe without the need of personal morality that evangelical Christianity insists upon. The life of the one who receives Jesus by faith and abides in him and lives by Jesus' words becomes more attractive with age. The lives of those who remain alienated from the God of love and mercy usually become decidedly uglier. The story of Henry Ford, at one time the richest man in the world and certainly one of the most influential men of the 20th century, serves as a cautionary tale to us all, but especially to those who drink the heady wine of success. Regardless of how much success God graciously grants us, no matter how many people may stand by our side and tell us how great, how talented and brilliant and wise we are, we must never forget that we are, in the end, just common men and women, desperately in need of Jesus and very much in need of humility.